So let us start the lecture. Fundamental theorem of gravitation. So theorem is fundamental theorem of Galois theory. The statement of the theorem is: let f(x) be a polynomial in f(x). Let f(x) be a polynomial in f(x). Let f(x) be a polynomial in f(x). K its supreme field. K its splitting field, K इसका splitting field है, over over f, ये भी the splitting field of f(x) over f, and G K F its K. So let's first define the Galois group, okay? Galois group हमें पहला define करना है. And GKF its Galois group. So Galois group क्या होता है? अगर आपके पास है ना K, अगर होगी normal extension F की, या K अगर होगा होगा किसी supplanting field, किसी polynomial f(x) का which is over capital F(x), then this group GKF which fixes every element of F, the group of automorphisms fixing every element of F, is called the Galois group. Okay, इस group का नाम है Galois group. तो इसमें condition ये है कि ये K होना चाहिए normal extension F का, या K should be the splitting field of some polynomial F(x) over capital, because they are one and the same. Things as we have seen in our theorem that K is normal extension of F if and only if this K is a splitting field of some polynomial f(x) over capital f(x). So then this group GKF, it's called the Galois group. This group ko hum us time kehte hain Galois group of the polynomial f(x). So f(x) is a polynomial in f(x), and K it's a splitting field over f, and GKF, which we call the Galois group, it's called the Galois group of f(x). Then for any subfield T of K containing f, T of K, that means it lies between K and f, containing f. Let GKT, and let's define GKT. What's GKT? Let GKT, it is a set of automorphisms fixing the elements of T. So GKT, those automorphisms in GKF such that they fix every element of T. Sigma T is equal to T for all T in T. For all T in T. And for any subgroup H of GKF, and for any subgroup H of GKF, okay, we can define its fixed field. For this subgroup, और इन्हें सब ग्रुप एच एफ जी के है, लेट के एच बीट स्प्लिट फिर लेट लेट के एच, व्हाट्स के एच, के एच मीन्स दोज एलिमेंट्स ऑफ के, दोज एलिमेंट्स ऑफ के such that they are fixed by every member of H, such that sigma x is equal to x for all sigma belongs to H, for every automorphism of H. Then the association of T, then the association of T, then the association of T, then the association of T with GKT, with GKT, this association, for every T we can define GKT sets up a 1-1 correspondence, sets up, means there is a bijection actually, sets up a 1-1 correspondence, 1-1 correspondence sets up a 1-1 correspondence of the set of subfields of K of the set of subfields of K containing F, K containing F. And the set of subgroups of मुझे अब नेक्स्ट पेज पर ये लिखना पड़ेगा एंड द सेट ऑफ सब ग्रुप्स ऑफ जी के एफ एंड द सेट ऑफ सब ग्रुप्स ऑफ जी के एफ एंड the set of subgroups of GKF such that first part this T it's equal to the fixed field of this it's fixed field of GKT it's fixed field of GKT. So this means the fixed field of GKT. So T. Second is H is equal to it's GKKH. GKKH. And third part is the degree of K over T is equal to order of GKT. Order of GKT and the degree of T over F is equal to the index of GKT, it's equal to index of GKT in GKF. GKT is a subgroup of GKF, so we have an index that's called this, the number of the cosets of GKT in GKF. Actually, fourth part of the theorem is T is normal extension of F. T is normal extension of F. If and only if, this is very interesting, this one, GKT is a normal subgroup of, is a normal subgroup of GKF. GKF. GKT is a normal subgroup of GKF. The last part of the theorem is when T is normal extension of F, when T is normal extension of F, when t is normal extension of f, then gtf is isomorphic, then g, then gtf, then gtf is isomorphic to this quotient group gkf. Over g k t, because whenever t is normal extension of f, then g k t is a normal subgroup g k. That's part 4 actually. So this is well defined. This is a quotient group g k f over g k t, because g k t is a normal subgroup g k t g k f by part 4. These are 5 parts of the theorem. So it's given that now in the statement that K is superlating field, so that means K is superlating field of fx over f. It's also superlating field of fx over any subfield t. Okay. So let's prove the first part. Let's prove the first part of the theorem. Then we prove this one-one correspondence. Okay. First we prove these two parts, t equal to k g of kt and h equal to g k kh. ये दो parts हम पहले prove करेंगे. इसके बाद हम one on correspondence prove करेंगे. Then we will prove third, fourth and the fifth part. So first part t is equal to k g kt. ये actually हमने किया है. Second part को भी हमने असल में किया है. This h अगर k normal extension होगी f की, तो उस case में h अगर हम लेंगे subgroup g k f का और k h को डिफाइन करेंगे फिक्स इक्वल g k f का, देन h इक्वल g k k. दिस ऑलरेडी डन दिस थिंग. दिस वन फर्स्ट पार्ट आपको चेक करना है. सेकंड पार्ट हमने ऑलरेडी किया है. ये दो पार्ट्स हमारे देख लेंगे और वो वन कॉरेस्पोंडेंस भी हम चेक करेंगे. प्रूफ ऑफ फर्स्ट पार्ट. Now this f x is a polynomial over the field f. Okay, therefore it's also a polynomial over the field t, because t contains f. Since this k is a superlating field, is a superlating field of f x over f. Therefore, it's a superlating field of fx over t also. There, because we can treat fx as a polynomial over t also, because this t contains f. So therefore, k is a superlating field. It's a superlating field of fx over t also. Over t. Or subfield, you can write or subfield t containing f, koi bhi subfield of it. Therefore, that we have already seen the theorem. Therefore, this k is normal extension of t. Therefore, k is normal extension of t. So if k is normal extension of t, so that's the definition of normal t. Thus what will be the fixed field of this? So therefore by definition of normal t, the fixed field of, now it's this k is normal extension of t, fixed field of g k t is t. That is, this t is the fixed field of, it's a fixed field of g k t. So this is the definition of actually normal t. If k is a normal extension of t, then t is the fixed field of g k t. दैट प्रूव्स पार्ट वन, दैट प्रूव्स पार्ट वन. नाउ वी प्रूव पार्ट सेकेंड. नाउ वी प्रूव पार्ट सेकेंड. सेकेंड पार्ट. Since k is a normal extension, since इसको भी हम इसमें ये भी हमने actually already किया, this one we have already done. Since k is a normal extension, because there is a polynomial f x over f which splits completely over k, so therefore by that term this k is normal extension if and only k is splitting field of certain polynomial. So that means this k is a normal extension. It's a normal extension of f x. Over F. Sorry, we don't need to write here. Normal extension of capital F. It's normal extension of F. यहाँ पर हमें polynomial लिखने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. Now is a normal extension. So this K is a normal extension of F. K is a normal extension of F. K is a normal extension of F. Now by that theorem, so therefore given a subgroup, therefore given a subgroup H of GKF, if we define KH, the fixed field of this those axes in K such that sigma x is equal to x for all sigma belongs to H, then this H is equal to G K K H. तो आपने दो चीजें एक्चुअली देखी. एक तो आपने ये देखा, अगर आप सब फील्ड लोगे F K का जो K को जो F को कंटेन करे, then you can find a subgroup of G K F. Then you can find us. That's called a GKT actually. Then you can find GKT, which is subgroup of GKF. And conversely, if we have a given subgroup H of GKF, then we can find a subfield of K which contains F. We can find a subfield of K which contains, because this K H, it definitely contains this K. It contains F. Okay, this K H, it contains F. And this thing holds, this F is contained in KH and KH is contained in K. तो दो चीजें आपने देखी. एक तो ये है कि अगर आप F और K के दरमियान कोई सब फील्ड लोगे, say T, then you can find GKT, which is a subgroup of GKF. Conversely, if we have a given subgroup H of GKF, then we can find a subfield of K which contains it. So that's why there is one correspondence actually between the subgroups of GKF and the subfields of K containing F. Subfields of K containing F. So this is actually part two. Now we prove the one correspondence. So that actually I have already discussed. So moreover, it shows that ये जो second part है ना, it shows first and second part. It shows that. देखिए आपने क्या लिया, आप इसको फिर से देखिए. मैंने लिया H किसका सबग्रुप, जी के एफ का. ओके, मैंने H लिया सबग्रुप जी के एफ. ये H किस फॉर्म का गया, ये इस फॉर्म का गया. सो गिवन अ सबग्रुप ऑफ जी के एफ, दैट सबग्रुप मस्ट बी ऑफ दिस फॉर्म जी के के एच, जी के के एच. सो एवरी सबग्रुप ऑफ H arises इन दिस फॉर्म एक्चुअली, where this KH lies between F and K. That's the next line which I'm going to write here. Moreover, this shows that any subgroup of GKF, जो भी subgroup of दोगे GKF का, any arises in the form. Arises in the form GKT. ये इस फॉर्म में arise होता है, GKT, where T is a subfield of K, where T
इज ए सब फील्ड, इट इज ए सब फील्ड ऑफ के कंटेनिंग एफ, के कंटेनिंग एफ, इट इज ए सब फील्ड ऑफ के कंटेनिंग एफ. So this T is a subfield of K containing F. So in this way, so there is an association of T with GKT. There is an association of T with GKT, for T we have a GKT which is a subgroup of GKF. This maps the all the subfields of T containing F onto the subgroups of GKF. So this is actually trivial. So hence there is an association. Association of T with GKT. So for every T we can define GKT, okay? T, association of T with GKT maps the, which maps, देखिए T maps onto GKT, actually which maps, T क्या है? T is a subfield of K containing a maps subfields of K containing F onto the subgroups of GKT, it is subgroup of GKF, onto the subgroups of GKF. So GKF, so this is actually ontoness, because for any subgroup GKF arises in the form of GKT, that's why this is onto. तो आप GKF का कोई भी subgroup लीजिए, वो GKT form का ही होगा. That means you have for every subgroup of GKF you can find a subfield of K containing F. So this association is onto this. Now check, this association is also 1-1. This association is also 1-1. That means given. Given two subfields T1 and T2 such that their images GKT1 and GKT2 they are equal, we need to show that T1 is equal to T2. So that's actually map is like this here. Map this T, you can define this map. T maps onto it's T is the element, and on this side we have the image. Okay, what's the image? Image is GKT. This map you have seen, this map is onto. Now we check, this map is 1-1. 1-1 के लिए क्या करना है? आपको दो एलिमेंट्स लेने हैं डोमेन से, मतलब दो एलिमेंट्स. डोमेन क्या है? डोमेन है यहाँ पर कलेक्शन ऑफ सब फील्ड्स ऑफ के कंटेनिंग एफ. तो आप दो सब फील्ड्स लोगे जो के को कंटेन करें, और आप अज्यूम करोगे इन दो की इमेज इक्वल है, एंड यू विल प्रूव दैट एक्चुअली दिस सब फील्ड्स आर ऑल्सो इक्वल. सो लेट्स टेक लेट T1 एंड T2 बी two subfields of K containing F such that their image, such that GKT1 is equal to GKT2. आपको प्रूव करना है T1 must be equal to T2. Now what's T1 here? You can see by part 2. Part 1 जो हमने किया, what's T1? T1 is actually the fixed field of this GKT. So T1 is actually this fixed field of GKT1 जो आपने part 1 से प्रूव किया. But what's fixed? So GKT1 is same as GKT2, therefore GKT1 is equal to K GKT2. But what's K GKT2? It's a fixed field of GKT2, which is equal to T2. It's by part 2. 2 में आपने देखा कि GKT का जो फिक्स्ड फील्ड है वो T है. जो ना पार्ट टू में आपने प्रूव किया, देयर फॉर व्हाट्स ए फिक्स फील्ड ऑफ जीके टी वन, इट्स टी वन, एंड व्हाट्स ए फिक्स फील्ड ऑफ जीके टी टू, इट्स टी टू, बट टी वन, सो टी वन इज इक्वल टू के जी टी वन, बट के जी टी वन इज सेम एज के जी टी टू, टी टू, सो देयर बिकॉज जी टी वन इज इक्वल टू जी टी टू, सो दैट मीन्स के जी के टी वन इज इक्वल टू के जी के टी टू, बट के जी टी टू इज इक्वल टू टी टू, सो देयर फॉर देयर इज अ वन वन कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंस, दस दस देयर is a one one correspondence, there is a one one correspondence between the subfields of K containing F, containing F and the subgroups of GKF and the subgroups of G, K, F. So we have completed part 2 and part 1 and part 2 and that this the one one correspondence, this we have done, this we have done. So next part is we have to show that this the degree of k over t is equal to order of gkt. That is already done actually, because t is a normal, k is a normal extension of t, so degree of kt is equal to order of gkt. This is also already done. So now we need to prove the this na index of ko prove karna, part third. Since k is a normal extension, k is a normal, इस पार्ट को आप करेंगे बिकॉज इट्स सिंपल, के इज अ नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ एफ, देयरफॉर व्हाट इज के इज अ नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ टी, सॉरी इट्स अ नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ एफ गिवन, सो इट विल बी नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ टी आल्सो, जो मैंने पहले एक्सप्लेन किया है, बिकॉज टी कंटेन्स एफ, सो देयरफॉर व्हाट इज डिग्री ऑफ के ओवर टी, इट्स इक्वल टू ऑर्डर ऑफ जी, सॉरी इट्स इक्वल ऑर्डर ऑफ जी के टी, ऑर्डर ऑफ जी के, इसको मैं रेज करता हूँ पहले, इट्स इक्वल टू ऑर्डर ऑफ जी के टी, तो ये आपके पास आ गया. नाउ वी हैव दिस दिस थिंग वी हैव ऑर्डर ऑफ जी के एफ. व्हाट्स ऑर्डर ऑफ जी के एफ? GKF, K is a normal extension of F, so order of GKF is equal to degree of K over F, and T is a field lying between K and F, so it's equal to degree of K over T, then multiplied by degree of T over F. ये आपने किया है, ये result है, तो basic result है extension पर. In fact, it's the first result on extension. Degree of k over f is equal to degree of k over t into degree of t over f, where t is a field lying between k and f. This thing, it's equal to what's degree of k over t? It's equal to order of gkh, order of gkt, sorry, order of gkt, order of gkt, it's equal to order of gkt, then degree of t over. So we have seen that this order of GKF is equal to order of GKT into degree of T over F. This we have seen. Order of GKF is equal to order of GKT into degree of T over F. So we have seen this. Order of GKF is equal to order of GKT into degree of T over F. So this means degree of T over F is equal to order of GKF divided by order of GKT. This GKT is a subgroup of GKF. So this one, this quotient, this the order, this quotient one, order of GKF divided by order of GKT, it's equal, it is by definition, it is equal to the index of GKT in GKF. So that proves part third. Degree of t over f is the index of gkt in gkf, is the index of gkt in gkf. So that proves these are three parts of the theorem. Now we need to prove part four and part five. For part four, we need a lemma. We need a lemma to prove part four, and that lemma is ये lemma आप खुद देख लोगे. इसका मैं सिर्फ statement लिख देता हूँ. ओके, इस लेमा का मैं स्टेटमेंट लिख देता हूँ. नेक्स्ट वी प्रूव द फॉलोइंग लेमा. नेक्स्ट वी प्रूव द फॉलोइंग लेमा. वी प्रूव द फॉलोइंग लेमा इसने किया है यहां पर, आप इसको देख भी सकते हो. एंड द लेमा इज, एंड द लेमा इज इफ K, sorry, if T is a subfield of K containing F, if T is a subfield of K containing F, okay, containing F, then the lemma states that T is normal extension of F. T is, ये हमने बता दिया के है नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन एफ की. ओके, के इज नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन, बिकॉज के इज नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ, के इज नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ एफ, इट इज गिवन. सो दिस गिव्स के इज आल्सो नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ टी. बट नाउ सिंस दिस एफ इट, दिस टी इट कंटेन्स एफ, सो नाउ वी डिस्कस द नॉर्मल टी ऑफ टी ओवर एफ. ओके, देन टी इज अ नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन. ये कब होगी नॉर्मल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ एफ? This is true if and only if, that you will see, it's true if and only if sigma of t, it's contained in t. That means for all t in t, sigma of t also belongs to t. For all sigma belongs to the, for every automorphism of GK. इस लेमा को आप देख लीजिए, ठीक है, this lemma. तो दिस इज डन एट पेज नंबर 248. इट्स वेरी सिंपल. इसमें भी कुछ पहले वाले रिजल्ट्स यूज हो रहे हैं, ये आप देख लीजिए दोनों साइड से. अब इसके दो पार्ट्स हैं जो हम कल के लेक्चर में करेंगे, बिकॉज इट्स वेरी बिग थ्योरम. ये एक लेक्चर में नहीं हो जाएगी क्योंकि आपके लिए भी ये हैवी होगा. तो आप इसको देख लीजिए अच्छी तरह से, उस लेमा को कीजिए. दिस लेमा इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अवर थ्योरम. Okay, this T, if T is a subfield of K containing F, then T is normal extension of F if and only if sigma T is subset of T for every automorphism sigma which is in GKF. Sigma T subset of T का मतलब क्या है आप? Sigma T subset of T का मतलब क्या? This means for all T in T, sigma of T should be in T. Okay, तो इसका मतलब ही है. This one. This is actually the definition. Okay, this is the definition. ये आपको प्रूव करना है, this if and only property ऊपर वाली. Okay, तो आज हम बस ये एक ही लेक्चर करेंगे इसमें. It's sufficient.